On June 7th, 1940, a child who would go on to be the most prolific serial killer in United States history would be born in Reynolds, Georgia. Samuel Little would spend much of his life moving around the country to different states, including California, Texas, and Florida. But soon after his birth, his travels would take him to Lorain, Ohio, where he was raised by his grandmother primarily, instead of his mother, who he claims was a prostitute. Little was a real peach, having racked up a mile-long rap sheet even before he committed his first murder, including a DUI, fraud, shoplifting, solicitation, armed robbery, aggravated assault, and rape. In his late 20s, he would move to Florida to be with his prostitute mother, where he would find work, ironically enough, as a cemetery worker and ambulance attendant. While it said his crime spree would begin in 1970, the first of the 8 murders he would eventually become convicted for would be a 1987 slaying of a California woman. This would not be the first time authorities accused him, however. Unlike his near triple-digit victims, Sam seemed to have incredible luck in the early days of his murderous rampage, starting first with his 1982 murder of 22-year-old Melissa LaPree in Pascagoula, Mississippi, who had gone missing the previous September. A grand jury declined to indict him for the murder. However, he was transferred to Florida during the investigation to be brought to trial for the murder of 26-year-old Patricia Mount, when prosecution witnesses identified him as having spent the night before her disappearance with her. But karma would again fail as the slippery slimeball escaped prosecution due to, quote, mistrust of witness testimonies. Not intelligent enough to see the walls were beginning to close in around him, he then took his talents to the San Diego area of California, where his primitive brain just couldn't help itself, and he was soon under arrest again for kidnapping, beating, and strangling 22-year-old Larry Barros, who survived. 1 month later, he was found by police in the backseat of his car with an unconscious woman, also beaten and strangled, in the same exact location as the attempted murder of Larry Barros. Amazingly, all this resulted in just 2.5 years in prison, and by February of 1987, he was again a free man headed to Los Angeles, California, where he would eventually commit over 10 additional murders. Incredibly, it wouldn't be until September 5th of 2012 that he would finally be arrested for a murder that would stick, a full 42 years after his crime spree had begun. It's not clear exactly how many murders Samuel Little committed in those 4-plus decades. The FBI has confirmed his involvement in over 50, and that alone makes him the most prolific serial killer in U.S. history. But other investigators have linked him to over 60, and Little himself claims to have killed a whopping grand total of 93 women across 19 states. He's currently serving 3 life sentences at California State Prison for the 8 murders he's convicted of. We can only hope the boys show him as much mercy as he showed his near 100 victims until he hopefully dies a very painful death. Rest in peace, Samuel.